Do you see them? Look closely. There's at least 20 different species here. We're talking lichens. Although we often glaze over lichens when talking about biodiversity, their presence, usefulness, and impact on the environment is vast. But not everyone passes them by. Lichenology is for people who appreciate the little things in life.
My name is Troy McMullin. I work for the Canadian Museum of Nature in Ottawa, and I study lichens. Unfortunately, most people, when you ask what lichens are, they don't know.
Lichens are not a single organism, but three organisms functioning as a single, stable unit. A complex life form comprised of a mutually beneficial partnership between fungi and algae.
They're really sensitive to air pollution, so they don't tend to occur in the cities very often. So more often than not, people have never really noticed the lichens because they don't see them in their own backyards. And so they're generally an underappreciated, lesser known organism.
Here are just a few ways you might have underappreciated lichens. For one, lichens are an important contributor to nutrient cycling, supplying nitrogen to soil for plant growth. They also prevent erosion. When lichens grow on top of soil, they are, in turn, stabilizing it. Many insects use lichens for camouflage, like this debris-carrying lacewing larvae, and some animals even make their nests out of lichens, like this tropical ruby-throated hummingbird.
This is Usnea longissima, or Methuselah's beard lichen.
Humans have found numerous uses for them as well. Methuselah's beard lichen can be especially handy around the holidays.
This one you can tell because it grows in single strands and it can grow several meters long. And it was the original Christmas tree tinsel. You know, they wrapped it around the trees back in the day, but it's hypersensitive to air pollution. So it's been disappearing globally. And the last place that there's sort of a stronghold for it is the west coast of North America. So it's a real sign of healthy, moist, old forests.
A lot of the time, lichens are so small, you can't even see them with the naked eye. A good lichenologist knows to keep a magnifier handy in the field.
So looking at lichens under a microscope is where they come to life. Unfortunately, they are, for the most part, in a really micro landscape. Imagine looking at a coral reef that's miniaturized, right? So these coral reefs are full of colors and shapes and beauty. You look under a microscope and then you just see all that again. It's the corals of the forest.
It just goes to show you never know what treasures can be found right in front of you, unless you look a little closer.